TJ DeSantis, Julie Kedzie, Memorial Hall, Kansas City, Kansas. Delboni in the pink, VanZandt in the blue. Brazilian taking the center of the octagon. The movement here from the New York native early.
Yeah, head kick attempt earlier from the southpaw stance. Looking to tie up and get things to the ground early on. But definitely, I like the way that VanZandt stays bouncing and she stays lateral in movement, even when she's moving, you know, up against the cage or she's moving backward.
Talk about the dynamic striking of VanZandt. Solid on the ground as well. Purple belt, been training Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu for 13 years. See if she can put it to use here on the floor. Kicks to the legs there by Delboni. Almost caught off guard, though, by VanZandt.
Yeah, she kicked to the inside of the knee right there, which was a smart target to hit by somebody in motion. You know, taken down by that single leg, but she was controlling the head and also bracing on the hips of Delboni, making it hard for her to pass the guard or launch any kind of big offense there.
Delboni content to throw these kicks, not allowing VanZandt to get back up, and also not allowing the referee to really force them to disengage with this. Attack still going on.
Yeah, generally referees don't let that bicycle position happen too long. You can see she looked for a get up right there, but she's targeting right below the knee at shin level, which will straighten that leg out, maybe right at the knee, but below the knee right there at shin level is a nice way to straighten that leg out and keep Delboni from launching power.
This position has deep roots in martial arts. This was the position that I refer to as Ali Inoki position because it was a position that Muhammad Ali fought Antonio Inoki in Japan a long time ago. And we see an issue there with the wardrobe. We see the service still.
Wow, look at the way VanZandt traps that that leg between her feet and used it as an opportunity to get up when Delboni responded.
Find your angle.
Combination missed there by VanZandt, but answered by a kick to the lead leg by Delboni.
It's the second time Delboni has caught a kick. Third time now. Unsuccessful in the takedown. Wow! VanZandt jumping up to that high guard positioning.
Rubber guard implemented here by VanZandt.
And she's locking, or she was locking her down by grabbing that foot and using it to adjust her position. Now you can see she's sideways, but still controlling the hip with that foot. Delboni's locking her up and trying to keep her in a pretzel position, but VanZandt very flexible and looking like she's setting up an omoplata.
I wonder if she has the ability to do so with that cage sort of keeping her from getting the right angle.
Yeah, that cage and Delboni's wrapping up her hip with her left arm is going to make that motion a little bit harder to do. But she could be going for a go-go platta right there.
That would be something. We don't see that every day in mixed martial arts.
And it actually is great in that positioning because then she can use vertical leverage as opposed to that horizontal spin.
This is a position where we see Delboni in top position. A lot of people feel that is the controlling position, but it's VanZandt that's doing most of the action here despite not having a lot of room to do so.
Yeah, not having room to do so. And, you know, here, like, the style that I would be doing is trying to look for a way to climb my way up, but Delboni's burying her head and actually preventing VanZandt from getting a brace against the cage for a get-up. Now you can see VanZandt getting that left butterfly hook to create space and sticking her fingers in the cage and pulling herself around.
Who's a foul unless the referee calls?
According to the first fight. Underhooking that, she underhooked the leg and now she's tying up Delboni's left arm. That's really beautiful positioning to that triangle.
Offensively not on the side of VanZandt. Still some time to work here, see if she can make something happen. Delboni content to just throw some strikes here, not a lot on them, but also not getting away from this position.
No, but that is the problem with underhooking in a guard of MMA. You're leaving your head very exposed, and Delboni's posture position there was preventing, you know, the choke from being locked on and the way she's maneuvering the right arm. You know, she is in a kind of a triangle guard, and now VanZandt is wrapping up her left arm, and she was wrapping her left arm, switching her legs out to get more, to tighten up around the neck. But I don't think it's going to be finished right now.
5 minutes in the books between these two atomweights. Round number two underway. TJ DeSantis, Julie Ketzi, Invicta FC 36 tonight live on UFC Fight Pass.
We saw, you know, Delboni grabbing for kicks, getting VanZandt on her back twice during the first round. Oh, nice inside leg kick.
We saw Delboni in top position through that first round. So far, content to kickbox. We'll see if she changes her attack. Lindsey VanZandt hasn't made it easy for her when she's in control on the floor. And right now, Delboni throwing some strikes off the kick of VanZandt.
And you can almost see Delboni's mind kind of working, like, I don't know, out loud when she got hit with that first kick, and then she timed the second kick for the takedown. Now it's VanZandt with the takedown, and Delboni on her back.
Delboni able to get back up to her feet. And back at space in the center of the octagon.
Use your up and down. Knee.
Stylistically, it's interesting to watch the way Delboni hunts for her attacks against the taller fighter. And the way VanZandt, you know, she stays in motion, but she stays lateral, she stays bouncing. She's looking for her openings, and she doesn't stay still, which I appreciate.
He's kicking in the lead leg of VanZandt by the Brazilian. Delboni relatively new to the atomweight division. This is only her second fight at 105. And she fought Ashley Cummins in her first effort in Invicta.
She has excellent awareness of where the center of the cage is. Another leg kick grab. You know, VanZandt's pulling. She's retracting the kicks a little bit faster there. It's getting harder to put her on her back. She's getting her hips back a little bit farther. But it's still a controlling thing. VanZandt with another takedown.
Seems she's able to secure this one a bit more. Looks like she is. Stepped over the legs here. Now goes to side. Nice elbows there by VanZandt. North-south position.
And here, where VanZandt is the taller fighter, she's going to try and probably stretch Delboni out and keep her from shrimping up, keeping her from launching any attack that'll get her legs in motion laterally. Delboni back to side control here, and, you know, attempting to shrimp, get that right, or excuse me, her left knee connected to her left elbow.
Nice adjustment there for Lindsey VanZandt, maybe going to try to frame up the kimura here.
Yeah, I was thinking an armbar there, but you're right about the kimura, and then she rolls to the back there.
Nice chain grappling here by the dancer.
Lovely. You know, and she's doing a nice job with that right underhook as well as she rolls.
On the back here. Right hook in, 2 minutes left to work.
Delboni controlling her right wrist and trying to get that arm over the head so that she can turn in because she's adjusting her position again.
Is the cage helping Delboni?
Yes. Yeah, you use that as a pivot point. You can almost cheese grate somebody's back if you get enough motion in. But VanZandt controlling the head and then again working for that underhook with her arm as she keeps her legs in motion. You really need to have very educated feet when you're trying to keep top control.
Able to maintain this position is VanZandt, body triangle. Delboni now putting her feet on the fence, maybe trying to make some space.
Get her hips lower, I think, so she can, you can set up an ankle lock right there. I'm not sure what she's looking at. I think she's mostly concerned about defending that choke and getting her hips to the side. Her chin is tucked nicely. She's really putting weight on that arm so she can turn in. VanZandt's making the adjustments and the punches so that she can try and wrap up that rear naked choke. She's really fighting for that, or possibly that arm bar.
VanZandt, again, a purple belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, but it's one she's worked on since she was 13 years old. And don't fall too in love with that belt color. Right now, fall in love with this rear naked choke attempt, though.
Yeah, you know, she's relentless there. Delboni had good defense, but she's turning it to that point. She's really connecting her hands, and it's across the jaw. Again, that's painful, but it's survivable.
Yeah, the Brazilian wills her way through it. Now covering up the mouth is VanZandt. Again, it's all about discomfort here, and I don't think Delboni's very comfortable.
No, I don't think she's comfortable either. And you can see the way VanZandt's stretching her legs out. She's setting up that leg. She's using it to pick her grip apart. Delboni's turning in. She's got to be careful of that arm.
Dying moments here in this round. Delboni able to get through that submission attempt. And touch of gloves, third and final underway. Nice right hand there by VanZandt, finds a home. Goes for it again, gets taken down though.
Delboni wrapped up right underneath her, and you know, it was almost as a VanZandt seated guard because I think she's very comfortable on her back. Setting up the high guard grappling was really successful for her in terms of shutting down Delboni's forward progression.
Looks like the Brazilian's trying to clear that leg and get into at least a half guard here.
She is, and you see the way that left under, butterfly hook is inserted so that VanZandt can get her hips free. Delboni's not shoving her up against the cage, trying to control there.
And again, we see VanZandt maybe flirting with that rubber guard. She bails on it.
You can see the position of Delboni's right elbow is kind of what was preventing that, the way she was keeping it that tucked. You have to get a little space under that elbow to get under the armpit. Looks like she got that space now.
We talk a lot about what the judges weigh, heavier control or attempts and movement. And Delboni in top position throughout this fight. We'll see if this fight goes another 3.5 minutes, if the judges will reward her for that. But the athlete's definitely making it hard to sort of figure out who is winning these rounds, with both fighters, you know, being in offensive positions despite being in traditional defensive positions at the same time.
Yeah, and you know what you have in your favor on top is gravity. Like, actually, I don't actually agree with that. I would have liked to see some more work down there, just because I liked the way Delboni was pushing up her neck up against the cage, and I liked the way VanZandt was working, but whatever, we're on our feet now. But yeah, gravity, when you're on top, that helps. You have to have that, use that to your advantage when you're striking. You have to have some kind of attack, or you're just holding.
Talk about positioning as well, you know, on the feet. You see Delboni constantly in the center of the octagon, and that can be rewarded a lot for the aggressive position. Octagon control, a criteria in judging mixed martial arts, and Delboni, I think, trying to say that, look, I'm controlling where this fight is taking place and the pace of it.
But much like, you know, top position, you really do have to launch a lot of attacks from right there. You might control the real estate, but if you're not, you know, if your output isn't high or it isn't strong, then the judges don't deem it, so I should say that. I think her output's great. You know, you are in a tight position. Up against the fence here, again, exhausting for the fighters. Often it is the fighter with their back to the fence who is judged against, but you can see she's doing a lot of work right there, and she's hitting those knees. I like Delboni's head control, though. I like her underhook. She's really keeping a nice pin there.
We talked about in the last round where VanZandt was making Delboni uncomfortable. That head position can really make your opponent uncomfortable, and I think Delboni trying to implement that same sort of pressure here in this third round.
You can see now VanZandt's reaching for that head raise. She's pushing against the head to create space and get her hips free. Delboni continues to attack, but VanZandt is able to make that punch.
Back at space, 90 seconds left in this atomweight fight. Lindsey VanZandt moving to the center of the octagon. Trying to find an angle is the New Yorker. That one getting some gas from this Kansas City crowd. Looks like VanZandt tried to initiate a clinch maybe for a takedown there, but Delboni shut it down quickly.
And you know, Delboni keeps her hands so low, but that is actually almost, it works to her advantage to get those underhooks because she's a little bit shorter. She's able to get underneath with those low hands, and the strikes don't necessarily connect. She's on the inside.
Spinning attack there a moment ago by VanZandt. Delboni was wise to it, able to initiate a clinch off of it. And again, control for the Brazilian. In the thighs there of VanZandt.
VanZandt was attempting that toss with her off of her right leg and then adjusting to bring her out. It's a nice way to, well, she's reaching around the head, and you can see Delboni shorter than her, so she's able to push her hips up. She's able to shut down that judo toss.
High guard here for Lindsey VanZandt. Time not on her side, final 10 seconds.
Go, 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 pull the hat. Keep with the triangle.
15 minutes in the books between these atomweights. We go to the judges' scorecards.
Ladies and gentlemen, having gone the distance, we go to the scorecards. Here are your score totals. Judge at Octagon side, Kevin Champion, scores the contest 29-28 for Delboni. Judge Greg DeFilbis scores the contest 29-28 for VanZandt. And Judge Stephen Graham has the bout 29-28 for your winner by split decision. Out of the red corner, Jessica